Hello everyone, my name is Katie and welcome back for a very spooky video today. I've always loved videos that are like, if you like this, then read this type of recommendation videos, but I thought in honor of the spooky season, I would do something a little bit different, put a little bit of a twist on that, and that is if you are scared of this, read that. To make yourself scared for the spooky season, I figured this would be the perfect video to post around Halloween, and I got my Halloween costume on. I am using the same cat ears that I always use when I want to be festive, but you want to know what? I love the cat ears, so I got some sparkly whiskers on. I really just improvised, but I think it came out okay. As the weather is changing in fall and it just gets more dreary and cold and the autumn sweeps in full force and it starts getting darker earlier at night, it just puts me in the mood to read something to scare myself. I want to be scared. I want to read about my fears on the page and have a reaction where I am afraid. So with that being said, I'm going to dive into some books that have to deal with certain fears that are very common and around in this spooky season. So without further ado, let's just jump on into it. Now, the first book is if you are afraid of the supernatural, not only ghosts, but different abilities, different things that go bump in the night, and yes, spirits that do not have your best interest in mind. And that series is going to be The Diviners by Libba Bray. The Diviners is set in 1920s New York and consists of The Diviners, Lair of Dreams, and Before the Devil Breaks You. Now, this is a series that has been so talked about every year around October, and for a good reason. It really is the perfect Halloween read. And I think with this series, each book gets scarier and scarier. The Diviners follows Evie O'Neill, a jazzy girl in the 1920s who just wants to escape her small town and go to the big city and make it big. She gets that wish when she is sent off to live with her uncle, who runs a museum of the occult. There she meets Jericho, his assistant, and all other sorts of characters that live in the city. But Evie has a secret. She can read objects, meaning she can touch an object and divine its past. When Evie goes with her uncle to the scene of a murder, she divines an object and gets roped into the case of the mysterious Naughty John, a spirit that definitely wants to do harm to this world. And it's just like the 1920s slang is amazing. There's so many important topics that are sprinkled within the series, but also it is just so creepy. And every book, the villain gets creepier and creepier. The last book, which has been the underlying villain throughout the whole series, The King of Crows, is coming out in February. And I know it is just going to keep me up at night. Super scary. The next book to read if you are scared of ghosts or the occult is Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. I mean, this book is just so talked about right now. It is probably one of the most overhyped books on BookTube right now. Ninth House follows Galaxy Alex Stern, who has survived a multiple homicide and is the only survivor. She is the most unlikely member of Yale's incoming freshman class, but when a secret society discovers what Alex can do, they recruit her. Once at Yale, she is tasked with monitoring the 8 secret societies. Their occult activities are more sinister and horrible than anyone can imagine. They raise the dead, and sometimes they prey on the living. If that doesn't sound like the perfect Halloween book to get you in the mood to be scared if you are afraid of occult activities, I don't know what does, but I cannot recommend this book more for a nice, scary autumn read. The next fear is monsters. If you're afraid of monsters, the perfect book to read this fall is The Devouring Grey by Christine Lynn Herman. I'm actually surprised that this book came out in like April, May, because it is such a perfect autumn read. This book, honestly, was very scary. It gets kind of pitched as a Stranger Things meets The Raven Boys, and I think that's very accurate. The Devouring Grey is about Violet Saunders, who goes back to live in her mother's hometown of Four Paths, New York. If you know anything about upstate New York, you know in the autumn it is one of the spookiest places that you can be. There's just something about the atmosphere and the small towns there that really just makes you feel like there could be another world out there, which in this book is the Grey. Violet befriends the other children of the founding families who are each tasked with a special ability in order to guard the town from the Grey. The Grey is an alternate dimension within this town, and it is growing stronger day by day when Violet accidentally unleashes a monster. The children must band together before the Grey devours them all. Look at this spooky forest end page. This is literally where you are transported to when reading this book. It is the perfect atmospheric and scary read, especially if you are afraid of monsters. The next monster book I have is This Savage Song by Victoria Schwab, which is followed by Our Dark Duet. This is Victoria Schwab's YA duology. Let me just read you the poem on the back to set the tone. Corsai, Corsai, tooth and claw, shadow and bone will eat you raw. Maokai, Maokai, sharp and sly, smile and bite and drink you dry. Sunai, Sunai, eyes like cold, sing you a song and steal your soul. Monsters, monsters, big and small, they're gonna come and eat you all. That just sounds like the perfect monster book. And let me tell you, this book is scary at times, but it also has such a big emotional punch. This Savage Song is set in a city on the brink of war, where every monstrous act committed by a human creates a monster. Depending on the type of act, the type of monster is created. Kate Harker is the daughter of one of the most ruthless bosses in the city that is set on controlling the monsters and using them for his own game. August Flynn, however, is a monster who wants to be human. But he isn't. He can steal souls with a song. Kate and August are the only two that see both sides and the only two that can do something. This is just kind of like a mix between like dystopian and fantasy, and the monster system in this is just really, really freaking cool. We're going to get a little bit meta with this one, but if you're afraid of death, the perfect book to read is Scythe and Thunderhead by Neil Schusterman. Scythe is a book that is set in a world where there's no hunger, no war, no misery, no death at all, except for the scythes who can choose to glean you at any moment to control the world's population. Citra and Rowan are chosen as unwilling apprentices to a scythe and must learn all there is to the act of gleaning or killing a person. These teens must master the art of death, knowing that the consequences of failure can mean their own life. I really think that this book just takes a really big look at humanity and what it means to die and what life would be like if there was no threat of death except by this person that can just bring death to you randomly. It's very chilling and thought-provoking and is perfect if you want to scare yourself about the thought of death. Next up is, if you are afraid of vampires, read The Beautiful by Renée Adier. This is a book that was just released this October, and it is set in the 1800s New Orleans, where Celine Rossio is fleeing from her life after something terrible happened to her in Paris. She's taken in by a convent, but soon finds herself embroiled in the glitzy, glamorous world of New Orleans, especially the underworld, known as Le Coeur de Lions, led by none other than Sebastian Saint Germain. When a body of one of the girls from the convent shows up dead in Sebastian's lair, Celine battles her attraction to Sebastian with suspicions about his guilt. After a third murder, the murderer has his eyes on Celine and is stalking her to no end. Celine takes matters into her own hands and finds herself in the midst of an age-old battle between creatures of the night. This book is really cool because we are reading mostly from the perspective of Celine, and we are discovering about the monsters as she does, so we don't know everything about the vampires off the bat, but we get to slowly unravel what's going on from a girl that just thought that everything is normal and suddenly finds out that the paranormal exists, and it is perfectly spooky and chilling for this Halloween. And last up on the list, if you are afraid of some good old-fashioned serial killers, please read the Stalking Jack the Ripper series by Carrie Maniscalco, which consists of Stalking Jack the Ripper, Hunting Prince Dracula, Escaping from Houdini, and Capturing the Devil. Stalking Jack the Ripper follows Audrey Rose Wadsworth, a highborn lady who apprentices in her uncle's forensic lab. While she should be at tea with the ladies, all she wants to do is cut open dead bodies and learn their secrets. With her uncle, she gets drawn into the investigation of none other than the infamous Jack the Ripper, and her search for clues brings her further from her sheltered life than she's ever known before. This book is really cool because it's inspired by this unsolved case, and other books in the series are inspired by other unsolved cases or mysteries folklore that has been around for a long time, and it's really cool how it's incorporated. And there are some things that are really scary. I mean, like the real life Jack the Ripper letters are incorporated in here, and just things that happen. Very, very scary. One of the most famous cases, and I recently read Hunting Prince Dracula, which takes place in Romania, and it was equally, if not more, scary. I really had my heart was racing at some points of reading this book. It was just phenomenal, and I know that the other two books are probably phenomenal, and I can't wait to read those soon because this is the perfect time of year to read them. All right, that was my short little Halloween list of some books to get your blood pumping from fear by facing your fears and reading about the things that you are afraid of. Let me know down below what you are afraid of and what book made you the most afraid, and have a happy Halloween. Have some fun, read some books, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.